Hello students, the question is, a straight rod of length L extends from x equals to a to x equals to L plus a. The gravitational force is exerted on a point mass m at x equals to 0. If the mass per unit length of the rod is a plus bx square is given by. So try to understand the question first. This question is taken from JEE Mains 2019, 12 January, first half. A straight rod L extends from x equals to a to x equals to L plus a. So, this is the x-axis, okay? This is x equals to a, and this is x equals to a plus L, and a rod is placed like this. This is the rod. Okay, student. The length of the rod is thus L. A point mass is placed at origin, that is at x equals to 0, and the mass is m. Now, in the question, if the mass per unit length of the rod is a plus bx square, and that is known as mass per unit length, is nothing but linear mass density. Linear mass density. Now, linear mass density, suppose I denote it by lambda, is given as a plus bx square. So, this is not a uniform rod, okay? Its linear mass density, lambda, varies with x according to this formula, a plus bx square. Now we have to calculate the gravitational force acting on this mass m due to this rod, right? Gravitational force acting on this mass m due to this rod. Okay. We all know the formula to find gravitational force between two point masses. And the formula says capital F is nothing but capital G m1 m2 divided by distance square, right student? This is Newton's law. Now this law is applicable only when the mass is point like. See, the first mass is point like, but the second mass is this rod. It is not a point mass and it is not a uniform rod also. Therefore, let us take a small element of mass like this of the rod, which is situated suppose at distance x, and the length of this small element suppose is dx, right student? Therefore, since this length is very small, this dx length is very small, I can consider this as point mass. Okay. Therefore, mass of length dx, which is infinitesimal small element of the rod, is what I may denote it by dm. It is nothing but the linear mass density of the rod into this length, because this lambda is nothing but mass per unit length. Therefore, mass of dx length is what? Lambda into dx. ठीक है? ये lambda क्या है? This is the mass per unit length. Therefore, if you want to calculate the mass of this dx length, we have to multiply this mass per unit length with dx. Putting the value of lambda here, a plus bx square into dx. So, this is the infinitesimal small element of mass, or you can say this is the mass of this portion, right? Now, we have to calculate the force acting between this small m and this dm. Therefore, force between m and dm. Let us denote the force by df equals to capital G into m into dm by distance square. And the distance is obviously x, so x square. Right? Now, you have to put the value of dm here. So df equals to capital G m dm divided by x square, putting the value of dm here, a plus bx square dx by x square, right? Now what about the direction of this force? Remember, this force is not scalar. So before integration, you always think of this thing that we have to take the consider the direction. Now see, this is x equals to 0 and the mass m is placed here, and this is the rod, right? This is the rod. Now for that small element of mass dx, for small element of mass dx which is here, I can say that this dm mass and m mass will attract each other, therefore force acting on this m mass will be towards this direction, right or wrong? And you can say for all the elements of the rods, the force is attractive and attractive, therefore net force acting on small m due to the entire rod is nothing but integration of df. So gm is constant, integration a by x square plus b whole into dx, and the limit, what is the limit? Limit will be from this to this, right? That is from x equals to a to x equals to a plus l. This is l. So the limit is, lower limit is a and the upper limit is a plus l. That is the two ends of the rod. Okay, let's do the integration. Gm, the first integration a, integration dx over x square, a to a plus l. And for the second part, it is b, integration dx, a to a plus l. So this is a very easy integration. We all know integration of 1 by x square is what? X to the power minus 2. So minus 1 by x, right? So this thing is a minus 1 by x, a to a plus l, plus this thing will become bl, just bl. It's very clear. So force will be what? Gm capital A 1 by a minus 1 by a plus l plus bl. And if you look at the option, there is an option like this: gm a into 1 by a minus 1 by a plus l plus bl. So this is gm into a into 1 by a minus 1 by a plus l plus bl. So option 2 is correct. Thank you for watching this video. Option 2 is correct. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, PhiSolver.